working at the car wash. Okay. Yeah, so it's an exercise ride, and got a little squeak action on the bottom bracket. That's a work in progress. I'll sort that out at some point. So it's going to 40 today, sunny, and a little breezy, water packed, nutrition bar packed, and in the mood to run. Maybe we'll explore around the Hackensack, Lodi. Bit of an uphill. A lot of aggressive drivers today, so we're gonna ride up to Hackensack, Lodi area, but we're gonna do it by sight. No GPS, no reminder. So I pulled over a moment to adjust the rear brake a little. We got a lot of documents, right? Property documents, belongings. I like to keep the brake pads pretty close, but also too close and you wind up with some friction and you overheat the motor and the controller. I've seen a Corvette back there, the Shelby Cobra colors, the Shelby stripe, and I'm curious, did Shelby have any involvement in Corvettes? Let me know in the comments. The Beacon Diner. Looks like beacon, bacon, I don't know. Looks like a strip of bacon, right? Yeah. I've mentioned that previously, but I still think about it. It lives rent-free in my head. That's some quality driving. So we have a full battery, 35 amp hour, 48 volts, and plenty of juice. We have slime in the tires, in the tubes. This guy's gonna squeeze me, so I can't pass him. You see how far he's leaning to the right of the lane. That's the SUV sag. as we're making the lift. And yeah, so we're kind of boogieing along. We're gonna go straight down here. I forget the name of the street. I think it's like East Forest Avenue or something like that. We'll find out. I'm gonna take sidewalk for this, just to take advantage while it's here. That's all. I think we're in the general area. People like to beep for no reason sometimes. But watch out for the branches. Recognized prospect. We'll take the sidewalk here. Sure. Hillside. Harrison. Christie Heights. Lakeview. The ice cream shop here, it's still here. I haven't gone this route in a long time, in a car basically. I don't get up this way that often, in a car. Yeah, I'm thinking it's Passaic Street or something like that. I'm trying to remember. I'm trying to do this by just by memory, yeah, by sight. I want to see how easy it is without a... I think we found it. First Avenue. Yeah, let's back up the entire roadway. The last time we came this way, we had a tire issue, but I did not have slime in the tires at that time. Actually, that time, because it happened to be a slow leak, spurred me to use slime. Because I realized that, well, if I'm able to get a slow air leak and make it back home, if I had slime, I wouldn't even have noticed. Yeah. So this is not really a strenuous ride. It's actually kind of taking it easy because it's a lot of flat land. Small hills, which the motor can handle mostly. Nice bump. They really don't maintain these roads. Yeah, East Forest Avenue now. Glass. So this is the route I took when I came to Garden State Plaza Mall that time. let's cut into Teaneck, this section. I believe we gotta make a left. So there's a shorter way to go, slightly shorter. You cut out an elbow of the route, but the problem with that route is it's a little more hazardous, a little more complicated, difficult. This is more simplified. Remembering right, I think it's Passaic Street or something like that. I could be way off. Bike route. sure there's people who know the area better than me that would say, oh, you're going the wrong way, you're going the wrong way, yeah. It's totally road. If I get a little lost, I'll just bail out and go home. That's basically it. But I think we did go the wrong way. I probably was supposed to go down Cedar Lane. So the other roadway is over there. I could probably go there, but I'm gonna bail out. Cause like I said, I didn't really plan this trip. Just kinda, I wanted to see part of it. The main part was a couple miles back where I found my way to Forest Avenue. I wanted to find a simplified route for that, without relying on the local streets. And I did that, so that's a success. So we'll just head back. So it's not a ride to Hackensack. It's just a ride to a clarified route. So it's a ride to Teaneck. And back. So probably when I get home, I'll review my route and see. Probably Cedar Lane is probably where I should have gone, and that would have taken me right into Hackensack. And then that would take me to Tank Street, now that I remember. I remember there used to be rail fans hanging out here all the time. The scanners, checking out the trains coming by and all that. I haven't seen that in a long time. Maybe it's a more spring and summer activity. Quite the bumpy. Try a little something. And normally I take the sidewalk around this section. But this is I-95. Enjoy the traffic. Oh, that wasn't so bad, actually. I was expecting it to be worse. So you gotta watch out for glasses. Sheet metal screws and things like that all around this area. You get some aggressive drivers in this section. Because they see it as a shortcut. Which it is. But, yeah. They don't need to go fast. We're gonna cross over. Squeeze. There's a cycle shop nearby that one time I bought something there and the one guy checked, had somebody check what kind of bike I rode in on and asked if it had pedals. I think he had a beef against e-bikes in general. And next time, like a year later, I came back. 2 years later, or a year later, I came back to buy some more things. And the item I was buying hid behind a cover. Basically, I think he was not wanting to sell certain items to e-bikers. So I'm like, okay. So I don't mention the place anymore. I won't go there anymore. I probably could have turned down that other street. I think I should have. That's Shaler Boulevard. We'll turn it at Elite. The street name that inspires confidence, Elite. I don't know, where do you rather live, an Elite or Walnut? Let me know in the comments. We've got a hill coming up. We've gone 16.5 miles. And we're coming up the hill. We can take it easy in this part. Low gear, pedal assist. Like throwing spaghetti on the wall, you know, trying to see what sticks, trying to figure out what street is what and all that. Trying to familiarize myself with the route a little bit better without a GPS. It would be good to know it without a GPS so that you know, any technical failure with a phone or with a GPS device, then at least I can find my way around, you know, on my own. And the main thing was I wanted to verify that I could find that section of the route up to the Queen Anne Boulevard. Queen Anne Road, whatever. Back on Virgo Line Avenue. Big old crane. They're not joking around with that. Thank you. So we're at 18.4 miles. Working our way back. Slowly but surely. See all sorts of things around this area on the road. So you guys getting ready for the springtime, summer, by starting your rides. Are you getting back into the routine? Unstiffening your legs. Getting your aerobics in. Building your endurance. I have a feeling it's going to be a good spring and summer. Especially for riding. Get your bikes ready, get them maintained. Do your diagnostics. Get your fitness levels up. We're at 19.1 miles. We'll sign off at the 20 mile mark. We're close to it. A 35 amp hour LFP battery. LiFePO4 lithium ferrophosphate. Nineteen and a half miles. We'll probably sign off just a little shy of 20 miles. So I think we're going to sign off now and let the video play out. So that's going to be the ride. And that's going to be the vlog.